What's up guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, we're looking at editing this particular image here in Photoshop 2021. I have a previous video of where I showed you guys how I went about post-processing a fashion editorial image in Capture One 21. So like I promised, this is a Photoshop one. So I've taken the liberty to retouch this image, right? So just so that we quickly run through whatever it is I did, so that I'm not going to waste anyone's time. Just know the processes in mind and try and learn and use them in your own way. So to every retouch, I always look at what exactly I need to do. If it's healing, if it's liquefying, if it's dodging and burning, if it's matching colors, if it's fixing or whitening eyes and feet, I have all those guidelines in mind. So if you're about to retouch, you should have these in mind just so that your workflow becomes easy and quick. So I'm going to open up my complete retouch. And the first thing you can see here is healing. So I did use the healing brush tool together with the clone stamp to take away a lot of blemishes on my subject's face. Also looking at her chest and all that, there were some blemishes I needed to take off the hand, on the outfit. And that was that. And as easily as it is, 70% of a good retouch always comes from healing. So invest your time in healing, learn how to heal appropriately in Photoshop. Next, I tried whitening the hair. Like you can see, it has a lot of yellows in it and I envisioned a white hair. So I'm just going to whiten it with the hue and saturation layer adjustments. When I open it, you can see the effect here in the yellows because the hair is made up of a lot of yellows. So to make it white, I just reduce the saturation and masked it out, just mask the hair out and also reduce the saturation. I mean the overall opacity on the said hue and saturation layer adjustments. Next in line, I did mention I wanted to liquefy, right? So liquefying the hips just so that it sits right with the image. I'm not saying her shape was bad, it actually complements her own body, but I feel like I can enhance it and make it look as good as it is supposed to look in camera. So to liquefy, you just need to create or stamp a visible layer on an empty layer, go to filter, and you can see the liquefy filter over here. Then you just tap on it, it sends you to this particular interface. Then just do whatever it is you have to do here. Just practice how to liquefy appropriately and not go overboard when it comes to liquefying. So next, I created a new empty layer, changed the blending mode to color, and picked up my brush tool, a flow of 5, sampled where I needed to fix or match the colors, then I'll use it to paint the other side. So let me see what I did. If you can see on the layer, I think on the hand here, somewhere around her chest area or her torso, under the neck, and this side of the hand too. So let me bring this back. I'm not sure you're really going to see it, but if you do, then that's a plus for you. Right, so that is skin color matching. Right after that, mostly I dodge and burn and color grade. But in this image, I did some little color grading because I had done a lot in Capture One. I just wanted to boost up the color grading and not using a selective coloring. So if I should open a selective coloring, I did add just a hint of blues into my blacks. And here in my yellows, I boosted the yellows on her skin ever so slightly. So if I should show you before and after, like you're seeing over here, I also did reduce the opacity just so that it doesn't go overboard. So if you've been with me on my journey editing in Capture One or Lightroom or Photoshop for one, you always know that I reduce opacity all the time when I'm using a particular color grading adjustment or noise or vignetting or say sharpness. Right, so next in line was the dodging and burning, and this is where most of the work was done. This is the reason why I edited this image and I'm trying to explain to you whatever it is I've done. Not that I'll be editing and you'll be seeing and I'll just be wasting a lot of time and I'll just fast forward it and people will complain. So to avoid all that, this is the dodging and burning. And when I open my dodging and burning folder, you can see hue and saturation layer adjustments clipped to my dodge and my burn respectively. Let me explain something. When you zoom in to an image, right, to every image, there are a lot of pixels in it. Depending on the camera you used, with this, I used a 6D, like I mentioned in my previous video. So 6D is 20.2 megapixels. So I have 20.2 million pixels on this particular image. So zooming in, you can see these separate pixels, and I'm sure you can see the different lightness of pixels as you can see here. Whenever you dodge an image, you increase the saturation of such an image or wherever part on the skin you're dodging. So let's say if I am to dodge this side, in as much as I'm increasing the lightness, I'm also increasing the saturation. When you burn a particular side, you are reducing the saturation. So if I should toggle off my saturation adjustment, where I dodged, which you can see over here, let me toggle before and after, you can see an increase in saturation on her skin, which isn't something I'm looking for. Same can be said for the burn. Where I bent, there has been a decrease in saturation when it comes to her skin color. So by clipping this saturation layer adjustment on the dodge, I go into my reds, pick up this range, selectively tackle where exactly I dodge on the skin, then I reduce the saturation accordingly, just so that it sits right with the skin and it doesn't look too saturated. Same can be said for the burn, but with the burn, I added saturation instead, so that the saturation levels match accurately. You can't perfectly do that here, so I think I'll show you also in the next one. So my dodging and burning, this is what happened. Then I come to my dodging and burning outfits. So I have a separate dodging and burning for the skin, just because I introduced a hue and saturation layer. With the outfits, if you take a look at the blending modes, they have the blending mode of luminosity, and luminosity just tackles the lightness values, not the color value. So I just dodge and bend the outfits and a little bit of the background just to add some depth to the image. After I whiten my eyes and teeth, just to make the image look better. So if I should open my eye whitening and teeth folder, all you see is a hue and saturation layer, which has each and every channel available from red to magenta, reduced in saturation. The photo filter is a blue photo filter, and next to white is a blue color. Like when I always say, the color next to white is blue. So yeah, introducing the blue filter, and I have my curves adjustment just to increase or introduce an amount of brightness into these dark parts if they're looking way darker. Hence the before and the after of the eye whitening, teeth whitening. After, I always have this check layer I create. So let me just run the action of this check layer. Right, I think I got this from PixinPerfect. There's a video where he explains check layers, and there was one that has to deal with hues. So with hues, if you take a look at the skin, the face in particular, compared to the torso area, you realize it has a little bit of you have brighter purple. You have brighter purples, which in turn looks like pink, and you have darker purple. So if I should turn on this hue matching, you get to see that these lighter purple have been toned down, and that's matching the hues on the skin. So if I turn off the check layer and turn this off, toggle this off and on, you do realize some parts of the image have changed in color. Let me show you what I mean. So when I come to this and I move this, or let's remember this is a -8, and I move this all the way to the right and take a look at the selection range over here, you can see that I have selected some parts of her skin which have yellows in them. And looking at the overall image, we're looking at a kind of reddish tone on the skin rather than yellowish tone. So changing this to -8 matches that reddish tone you're seeing. So any other parts which had that yellowish tone in there which has our range here, has now been turned into red. And now I have my hues on the skin matching, making the image more presentable. I also have what we call saturation check. So in the check layer, there's also a folder which has saturation checks available. If you have the time, go watch that video on his YouTube, PixInPerfect. So if you take a look at this, the brighter areas mean they are more saturation, like they are more saturated, and the darker areas mean they are less saturated. So if I should open my saturation check, I have desaturation and saturation. So there are some parts I really want to introduce saturation, there are some parts I want to take away the saturation. So when I turn this on, you can see that I've evenly matched the saturation over here and a bit over here, and even on her face. That is how good these check layers help me to make sure the skin looks good as possible. So let me just delete the check layer. He has a video, kindly go watch if I have the time and I go look for it. I'll just link it up or leave it down in the description below. After this, I feel like my background looks too bright, so I added a bit of vignette to this. With vignetting, I create a new layer and I pick up my gradient to make sure I have my radial filter selected, the reverse checked on, and all I have to do is make sure my foreground color is black, hold shift on the keyboard and drag all the way down just to create a vignette. And after creating a vignette, you can see my background becomes darker and the concentration all falls onto my subject. After I add some noise just to add a bit of reality to the image, and I also reduce opacity, of course. I sharpened the image and I selectively I added sharpness to the image, but I maxed it out and selectively painted some sides. So all I did was painting the hair, if you can see, let me turn on the mask, the hair, the eyes, the outfit, exactly, just the outfit alone, and the tattoos to be precise. And yeah, that's all there is to what I did in this particular edit here in Photoshop. So if I should toggle off the before and the after, the before and the after, this is what I did. Not something, it's not really a big deal to edit in Photoshop 2021. It's quite easy if you know what you're about, the direction you're going into, and it's going to make your workflow easier if you really know what you're about. So thank you for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe as usual. Don't forget to turn on the bell notification icon. Share this video. I'm going to leave a link down in the description to the raw file of this particular image. If you haven't downloaded it from the previous video, you can download it from this particular video. Edit it, send it to me, and let me try and critique it. I'm not expecting anybody to post this image because it's not yours. So when you post it and you tag me, I'm just going to block you, just so you know. So just edit, retouch, do whatever it is you have to do to it. Send it to me and let me critique, and let's see how best we can improve your retouching skills. Thank you once again. Don't forget to subscribe, share this video, leave a like on this particular video, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace.